Hi guys, this is Nikhil here from Immortals India, and I have with me Mr. Sid Joshi from NTT Gaming. Hi Sid.
Hi.
Pretty big day for us. Your takes on the tournament, about the format, and how things are panning out so far?
I just arrived an hour ago, and I'm very surprised to see the amount of people that are here. I'm very happy with the turnout, and I think I really like the format as well. You know, events like these where I get to see more local talent and youngsters play is very good for the Indian scene, because for the last couple of years we've had the same 10-15 players play. We haven't seen that new talent come up, and I think events like this is what will bring this talent up and get them into the profession.
Yes, definitely. And this is actually a better grooming ground as well for future NTT players, I would say. That we have already a prominent NTT CSGO team. We also have a PUBG Mobile team. So these can be proving grounds for the new coming and upcoming talent as well. What's your take on that?
Absolutely. I mean, that's the entire reason I'm here. You know, because we've already done it in Dota, where we got this 16-year-old kid 3 years ago, and now he's one of the best players of the country. I'm looking for that young kid who I've never seen before, because I've never been to cafes, but I want to see him here, maybe pick him up and groom him and teach him, and hopefully, you know, he's one of our players in the near future.
And unfortunately, due to certain circumstances, we could not acquire your services and NTT Gaming services for this specific tournament, given the fact that NTT Gaming wanted to practice for their said tournaments that are coming forth, right? And probably even the likes of Sai, Amit Rasu, and Poki, and the rest, they would have been an interesting mix in this. What do you feel?
Actually, I feel like, you know, even if we didn't have our busy practice schedule, I still think that the players who are playing in the professional circuit right now shouldn't play in this event, because, you know, if the same players play these events, I won't. That's five less new talent that I get to see because my players are playing. Instead, if, you know, next time we have an opportunity where instead of my players playing, maybe they pick up a team and they coach that team, or they nurture that team during your event. I think that's a better idea, because, you know, I want to see new talent. I'm tired of seeing Sai play for the last 3 years. I want to see some new talent, and that's what this entire event is about.
Definitely. So keeping that in mind, I also feel that we should also have a mixture kind of a thing. That's the reason why we've brought in this unique concept, say the two professional players and the amateur players. And that's the main reason why we have come out with this format. So changing gears and switching a bit to the organization bit. So we all know that NTT has been one of the most prominent organizations in India for esports. We've seen some tumultuous times as well. We've seen some rough patches. We've seen some off days. So how do you cope up with those things? How do you let your team cope up with those things mentally? And even, having a psyche problem when teams get demotivated and they just feel off.
See, I mean, if you're in this industry, if you've been in this industry a long time, you have to understand that this is a part of the job. No team stays at the top. You are at the top at one point, then you are at the bottom again. It's all about how fast you can rise. You know, you fall down, you get up again, fall down, get up again. The most important thing that we have in NTT is the relationships that we have built. So even when you lose, just because of how close we are in our real lives, it doesn't really affect us a lot. Because, yeah, we feel sad and we cry and all of that, but next day we are all cool again because, you know, we are friends. We don't hate each other. When you don't like the person sitting next to you and you lose, that's a lot of mental pressure. But when you're so close outside the game, I don't think the losses, the downs, they get to us a lot.
So if at all we pitch in a probable matchup with your NTT lineup, which I, in my personal mindset, would say it is the strongest till date on paper. And say we pit them against the winners of MESC, would you be up for that?
Absolutely. I mean, I would definitely be up for that, because, again, as I said before, I want to scout new players. I want new players coming up in India, because it's high time now that there has to be one young kid. There's just so many people in India, and for the last 3 years, I haven't found one single kid who can take India to the next level. I think that's bullshit, and, you know, events like this is where these people will come up, and I would absolutely be up for, you know, having like a show match or something of that sort.
Okay. And you're known for your quirky bit, and you're known for your chirpiness of, you know, like teasing the other organizations and having a fiddle around with them. So do you feel that any other organizations other than, say, Global Esports and Entity Gaming, any other organizations are at par or, you know, like are scaling that well?
I mean, I don't know why you included Global Esports in that dialogue, because I don't think they are at par with us as well.
Okay.
But as long as India is concerned, I think we are the best. We are the front runners, considering all the games, all the game titles. And it's my personal responsibility to, you know, make Entity and make India proud on the international stage. So I don't think we have any competition right now, at least from the Indian orgs. But yes, orgs like Fnatic have come in and Vitality have come in, and we are still number one. So I think we are doing a great job.
Yeah, that's there. That's a commendable thing indeed. So just changing things a bit, what's your take on the PUBG Mobile scenario? Like you have Mr. Ghatak Gaming himself, you have Neo, you have Jonathan, you have big powerhouses. So what do you feel, how well are they going to scale in on the international scenario? What's your take on that?
I mean, if you look at how the team has performed in the last 6 months after they joined Entity, it just speaks a lot, you know. These players, they don't know how a professional org works, what scheduling is, what scrimming is, what practicing properly is. Mm-hmm. And joining an org where I have trained tier one players of other games before, I think the PUBG Mobile lineup is just going to scale from here. Last event we went to, we placed top five in the entire world. So, you know, we have already put India on the map. We are the best in India. And I think it's just going to grow from here and nothing else.
Great. So, just a personal question I would want to know. That do you feel that Indian talent is at par with the Europeans or the CIS region or per se the NA region? As an individual, what's your take on that?
Is there a particular game you're talking about?
I'm talking about CSGO. Because you've had certain players from those regions. Even on the Dota front, you've had a lot of international players coming in. So you've seen the circuit, how it has panned out. You've seen how the compatibility of players works. So what's your take when you talk of the Indian ecosystem versus the global ecosystem? And can we stand toe-to-toe?
To be very honest, I don't think Indian players are at the same level that European NA and CIS players are at right now. And you know, the majority, the biggest reason for that is there's so many good players out there. Every time you're playing a match, you're playing against someone who's much better than you are. And you're always as good as the opponents you play against, you know. Until and unless we have 50 really, really good players in India, I don't think we are going to reach that stage. But the simplest solution I see to get there is to stick in a team, you know, form that bond. I always believe that individually, I think we are not there yet. But as a team, you can always beat them. And we did get pretty close last time when we were at Zoe as well. We'll get there, but it will take a little time.
Yes. So in my perception as well, we are quite a bit far, and we still have a lot of grooming time is what I feel. So just a final take on the most important thing I feel is, can someone who's between the age of 15 to 21, would you tell him that esports is a viable career option?
Absolutely. I mean, I already have a 16-year-old kid, Jonathan. He's 16. He's making good money. He's got a fan following. And absolutely, I think it's the right time in India right now to get into esports, with how PUBG Mobile is growing, with how CSGO is growing. And I would definitely, and I'll be, you know, if you're watching and you need help as a young kid who wants someone to talk to their parents or just needs advice, I'm always out there. So I would definitely say yes to that.
So, yeah, so that's about it. That was Sid Joshi, guys. Thanks a lot.
Thank you.